What patients are not the best candidate for the new Panoptix trifocal lens implant? Hello, I'm Dr. Tokuhara, and in today's video, we're going to talk about situations where the Panoptix lens is not the best choice. So if you're having cataract surgery soon, come along and follow me. In 2019, the FDA approved the use of the Panoptix lens for cataract surgery in the United States. Even at that time, globally, there had already been over 100 million eyes implanted with this new lens. The Panoptix lens delivers near, intermediate, and far vision for that trifocal or 3 points of focus vision. So patients looking to be more independent from glasses and not have to wear the glasses as often, the Panoptix is an excellent choice because it delivers near, intermediate, and far vision with better clarity than we could ever do before with the older technology. In fact, it's a lot easier now when it comes to options for the advanced technology lens implants. It was not too long ago, 1 year ago, that we would have discussions with patients with difficult terms like modified mini mono vision, mix and match. These terms we no longer have to do. With the Panoptix lens, we can talk about near, intermediate, far vision for both eyes with that trifocal, multifocal lens implant. In my practice, we spend a great deal of time in our preoperative assessment looking at different biometry measures of the eye, such as corneal topography, to select the best patients for the Panoptix lens implant. In the FDA studies, 99% of people after cataract surgery with the Panoptix lens say they would do it all over again with the same lens implant. Patient satisfaction is high. In fact, over 90% of patients with the Panoptix lens are able to achieve complete glasses independence. That being said, it's not a perfect lens, and there are some shortcomings to it. In the next section of this video, we'll talk about 5 categories of patients that might have a harder time achieving that 100% no glasses ever needed for the rest of your life with the Panoptix lens implant. The first category would be anyone who does a lot of activity, actions, or hobbies at night. This would be patients who, like firefighters, like night soundboard engineers, concert, DJs, people who do a lot of night driving. The Panoptix lens just doesn't work as well at nighttime as it does during the day. In fact, people who have the Panoptix lens notice this as well. It's a lot easier to read without glasses when they go outside, when they turn the lights up high in the room. So it works a lot better if the light condition is bright. When it's dark, the contrast just isn't as clear. So if you're the type of person that does a lot of night driving or a lot of work in the dark, take this into consideration when choosing and talking about the Panoptix lens with your eye surgeon. The next category, category 2, this would be patients who do a lot of work, hobbies, or activity that require a lot of detail. This would be patients such as artists, engineers, people who do drafting, or jewelry makers, because these activities require a lot of fine detail and contrast. Now, the Panoptix lens is wonderful. It gives you great flexibility of near, intermediate, and far vision. But in order to do this, there is a slight reduction in contrast. So for people who do a lot of near work or a lot of fine detail work, there is a mild reduction in contrast that should be taken into consideration. If this is you, talk to your doctor about other options that might be more appropriate, such as a monofocal lens with reading glasses. Category 3 would be patients with a history of corneal disease or problems such as keratoconus, irregular astigmatism, a history of corneal refractive surgery such as LASIK or radiokeratotomy. Some of these patients, when we use the Panoptix lens, are not able to achieve 100% independence from glasses after cataract surgery with the Panoptix lens. Category 4 would be any patient with a history of macula or retina disease such as macular degeneration, epiretinal membrane with macular pucker, or diabetic retinopathy. These issues, if they're moderate to severe, would be expected to limit the final visual outcome. So for patients who have these sort of severe macular or retina disease, talk to your doctor about whether the panoptics lens still would be a good choice for you for surgery. Finally, category number 5, this is anyone with a history of severe optic nerve disease, problems like ischemic optic neuropathy, severe amblyopia. All of these would limit the final expected visual outcome. And for patients with this, you would want to talk to your doctor about whether you would still be a candidate for the panoptics lens. Anything that would reduce contrast or limit your vision afterwards would make you less likely to be able to achieve that near intermediate far vision with the panoptics lens implant. So that concludes with the 5 categories of patients who we look out for when we're screening for panoptics lens implantation surgery when it comes to cataracts. Let's review. Number 1, patients who do a lot of night activity or actions such as night driving. Category number 2, patients who need a lot of detail-oriented vision for work such as actuaries or jewelry makers. Category 3, this would be any patient with a history of corneal disease. Category 4, patients with macular disease. And finally 5, patients with history of severe optic nerve disease. Any of these 5 categories, if this is you, you definitely would want to talk to your doctor about whether you still would qualify for the panoptics lens implant. That concludes today's video about the panoptics lens implant. Thank you for watching to the end, and until next time, I'll see you on the next video.